Hey there. Welcome to Life, Noggin. Hey there. Welcome to another episode of Dear Blocko. This is the show where I answer your questions about your world and my world. Let's get started. Austin D. asks, Dear Blocko, why do some drugs cause intense dreams? Well, intense dreams that we can easily remember when we wake up, also known as vivid dreams, are caused by a number of different factors, including certain medications. These include beta blockers, used to reduce blood pressure, drugs for conditions like Parkinson's disease, and antidepressants. Scientists believe that these medications are able to affect dreams because of their influence on the sleep cycle, specifically the REM stage, which is when dreams are most vivid. Drugs like beta blockers, which are responsible for one-third of nightmares reported during clinical trials, and antidepressants suppress REM sleep. While it may seem like this would result in less intense dreams, scientists believe, from studying the effects of antidepressants, that they actually just delay REM sleep until later in the night. Antidepressants can also inhibit a certain neurotransmitter, which results in more disturbances to sleep structure. Second question up, Carmillo asks, Dear Blocko, can you explain what dyslexia is? My brother has it, and I want people to know what it is. Well, I'm happy to help, Carmillo. Dyslexia is a learning disorder that makes it difficult to read. While their intelligence level may be normal, individuals with dyslexia often read at a significantly lower level. This is because their brains process information a little differently when reading, using different parts of the brain that aren't as efficient. These characteristics and severity can vary, but those with dyslexia often have a hard time spelling, sounding out words, or they have a hard time with quick responses. It's estimated that up to 20% of the population have at least some symptoms. Dyslexia can make school more difficult, but with the right teaching methods, learning environment, and support, those with dyslexia are able to succeed. And now it's time for questions about me and my world. Mr. Mayor McCity asks, Dear Blocko, how many cities do you have in your world? Well, the animator obviously made Blocktropolis, that's where I live, but he also crafted other cities too. We have Stakesville, cows live here, we have Oldsburg, the old-timey animations live here, Mako's actually from there, and we have Snuggle Gumdrop City. It's not what you think. It's a city made of fire. The whole thing is on fire. Second question up, Pizza King asks, Dear Blocko, what happened to the journey of New Jersey? Well, Pizza King, I'll share the video slideshow of us getting pretty close to seeing the knowledgeable one. We made it to the secret cave in New Jersey. We got underneath and we were immediately greeted with traps. There were arrows, fire pits, snake pits, and a giant slice of pizza with a knife. We managed to get to the Knowledgeable One's secret chamber, but we needed to solve a riddle to get the door open. We couldn't figure it out. If you guys have any idea how to solve this one, please let me know. We'll go back. So do you have any questions about your world and my world? Let me know in the comment section below and make sure you use the hashtag Dear Blocko so I can find it. Want to watch even more Dear Blocko? Check out the previous one we did. Dear Blocko, what would happen if the air was 100% oxygen? Well, first off, the plants of the world would probably be pretty unhappy. As always, my name is Blocko. This has been Life, Noggin. Don't forget to keep on thinking.